Good morning, students. Welcome to today's science class. The last class, what you studied for that, we'll go for the continuation. And today class, let me explain that what is photosynthesis. Okay, what are the factors involved for the photosynthesis? Okay, let me explain that. Okay, what is the meaning of photo? Photo means light. Synthesis means, we can say that, prepare. Photo means light, synthesis means prepare. Okay, yes. So, or we can also say that put together. Put together. What it puts together, that we are going to study now. Okay, the last class I explained about certain components are necessary for the plant to prepare its own food. What are those components? What are the components we learn means? We discuss the component like carbon dioxide is important, and the second one is sunlight is necessary, and the third one, water is required, and fourth component, it's an chlorophyll. Okay, don't forget children, these are the four factors also we can say that. Four factors are, four components are necessary for the plant to prepare its own food. So all these factors put together and it synthesizes its own food is called as a photosynthesis. Now the question is that how it is possible for the leaf? Yesterday class I said that the leaves are food factories for the plant. The entire processing of the food, it will be prepared or it will be done only in the leaf. How it is possible, how the leaf can take all this, the four different types of the components, that we are going to study now. Okay, yes, the first one is the carbon dioxide. Where it is available? Yes, you rightly said the carbon dioxide is available in the air, or we can also say it's in the atmosphere. Okay, from the atmosphere, how the plant takes this, I said the leaf is the food factory. Okay, the lower, upper surface as well as the lower surface is provided with the tiny dot-like structures are called as stomata. There are microscopic structures. In higher classes we will study, less number will be present on the upper surface and more it will be present on the lower surface. Okay, you know textbook in the standard of the class 7, it is given on the surface. On the surface of the leaf there are tiny pores and these tiny pores are covered by the other layer, other structure called as God cells, and all together we call as stomata. Did you get my point? The pores are covered by the God cells, together we'll call it as a stomata. So we can see the tiny pore like structure like this. This is the tiny pore. Okay, and this tiny pore, we can say it is provided with the God cells. Okay, and this God cell, this is a God cell. Okay, then this God cells are present in the epidermal leaf. This diagram is given in your textbook. Okay, yes. Okay, this particular structure, tiny structure is called as a pore, and this is called as a God cells. And together, then we can name it as stomata. Children, did you get my point? On the surface of the leaf, there are tiny structures called as stomata. Through the stomata, this carbon dioxide reaches inside. Do you get my point? Okay, yes. And it goes inside and it will be settles there and it will wait for remaining all the factors, as all the components. So, with this carbon dioxide is reduced to carbohydrates in the presence of sunlight with the help of the chlorophyll, in the presence of chlorophyll. Okay, yes. So, the next one is sunlight. So, how it is, from where it gets the sunlight? Sun. Okay, let me say the first point, carbon dioxide, it is available in the air and through the tiny pores. Through the tiny pores covered by the God cells. It's covered by God cells and this particular structure is called as stomata. Through this stomatal pore, carbon dioxide reaches into the leaf. Okay, sunlight is necessary, and that plant gets from the sun with the help of the chlorophyll. Actually, what is this chlorophyll means? It is a colored pigment. It is a green colored color. Is green colored pigment. The green colored pigment is called as chlorophyll. What is the function of this green colored pigment means? This green colored pigment trap the solar energy and it waits near the in the leaf. Okay, three factors over. First is carbon dioxide from the air, sunlight is from the sun. The sun is trapped by the pigment called as a chlorophyll. The color of this chlorophyll is a green, and it is present inside the chloroplast, and the chloroplasts are the one of the part it is seen in the leaf. Okay, yes. Then my fourth essential part is water, H2O. How this water it will goes, and water otherwise we can also say that it is also requires the minerals. Okay, yes, the salts. And how all this will reaches into the leaf? How all this will be reaches into the leaf means, yesterday I showed the leaf and plant part I showed. So the plant has upper part, we can call it as shoot system, and the lower part. See, just have a look here. So this, as you are not having the textbook, just if you see here, we can see this is an above structure stem, and this is a lower structure. From the lower region to the upper region. When you are given water to the plant, the what will happen means from root to the stem, our leaves and the branches are made up of or provided with vessels. What are the particular structure called? We can call it as a vessels. Okay, how these vessels looks like? How these vessels looks like means they look like as a pipe-like structures. Vessels look like as a pipe-like structures. That is the reason when you are given the water under the soil, so what will happen? It is moving upward direction. Okay, unidirectionally the water it will be goes above regions. It is very interesting how the water travels. The water travels through these vessels. These vessels are just like as a pipe-like tubes which are present from the root, stems, either sides of the branches, leaves. Everywhere this particular the part it will be goes. See, once if you see that the stomata picture I drawn here. So when you the where this stomata is present over the on the leaf on the surface of the leaf, this stomata it will be present. Okay, so clear, children? Okay, so the vessels carry out, our vessels, they take out the water and from the leaf part, and all these together put together and prepare its own food. That particular process we'll call it as a photosynthesis. I hope it is clear for you. Once again, let me repeat the definition. Plant can able to synthesize own food by utilizing the factors like carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, sunlight from the sun, the water from the soil, and chlorophyll in the presence of the leaf itself. By utilizing all these factors, plant can synthesize its own food. It is called as a photosynthesis. Okay, children, I am giving the running note. Just I will use only the key points. Okay, don't be confused. No more the confusion for you. That just you read the textbook. And of course, you don't have the textbook right now. And as you downloaded the book, please just once you say, spend a time with them in front of the system. Then you will line to line, if you read, it will be clear for you. No need to worry anything. Once again, when the class schools reopen, we will explain very clear. This we are bringing close to the topic without wasting your time. I hope it is clear for you. Okay, children. So by utilizing these factors, the plant can it synthesize its own food. Okay, I say very clear, carbon dioxide through the spiny pores, they are called as a stomata. And the second one is the water, how it goes means the vessel-like structures, and vessels how they are means, they are just like as a pipe-like structures. Then from the root to the top they will be situated, and then water it will be moves to that particular regions. Okay, chlorophyll, where it is there? And it is present inside the chloroplast. The chloroplast is a structure, is present inside the leaf, and on the surface of the leaf, these are all microscopic, we can't see that. On the surface of the leaf, the chloroplast is present. It helps to trap the solar energy, and by utilizing these factors, plant can synthesize its own food. That particular process we call it as a photosynthesis. Okay, children. So let me give them equation. How it is the plant can. I'll write that down once you see that equation form you have to write. Okay, yes. What is the first factor? The factor like I said, carbon dioxide. And the second factor is water. And the third important factor is sunlight. Okay, and this is very important on the equation. So I hope you know that this is called as an equation. Equation in chemistry you study, equation is a combination of the reactants plus reactants gives us the products. Okay, these are the reactants, carbon dioxide and water, in the presence of, like that you have to read, in the presence of the sunlight and the chlorophyll, it prepares its own food, that is nothing but C6H12O6, and it releases the gas called as an oxygen, and it also produces a little amount of the water. Okay, it's in a symbolic way I written, and this carbon dioxide, CO2 means carbon dioxide. Okay, H2O means water. Okay, the same in the presence of sunlight. CHL means chlorophyll. C6H12O6 means nothing but, this is only the main product, carbohydrates. Along with the carbohydrates, which gas is releasing? The released gas is oxygen and water. Okay, and this is called as a photosynthesis. Okay, children, is it clear? The definition is clear. Okay, so the, let me explain the points called as how the other points we'll discuss. What is the structure of the leaf? How it will be? Okay, if you see the structure of the leaf, okay, this is of course the points are not given for you in your class. Maybe you studied in the previous class. This is called as a midrib, this is called as a lamina, these are called as a veins, and this is called as a veinlet. Okay, yeah. So I already drawn the tiny pore structure, that is called as a stomata. Take a small piece of this leaf, observe under the microscope, and we can see the different parts of the leaf. The diagram is also given. Just children, please you have to write. Cut a small piece, observe under the microscope, and we will see the structure like this. So this particular part is called as epidermis. Only when you cut the leaf, we can see this particular structures. Epidermis. This is provided with a thin layer. This layer is called as a cuticle, and below this, I don't want to give the names. In IC class, we'll discuss all these names. Again, we'll confuse if the names are not given. Why ma'am said this? Okay, this is a parenchyma. Okay, this is epidermis, cuticle, parenchyma. So, where this stomata it will be present? Where it is present means the most stomatal openings we'll see in the lower surface. Okay, here we'll see the more stomata. Actually, what is the use of this stomata? Where the stomata it will be present more? Lower surface the stomata is present. The main use of the stomata is, it in box it is given, children, please have a look. The main use is transpiration, exchange of the gases, elimination of the water in the form of an water vapor, excess one. So this is the structure of the leaf, and loose tissue also present. Here the tissue is somewhat tight, and loose tissue also we'll see. This is the name of parenchymatic tissue. So like this, internal structure of the leaf it will be present. Okay, yes, you know, textbook only they label this is the tiny pore, stomatal pore, and these are given as a God cells. Okay, yes, if you want this, let me, I'll say this is called as an epidermis, this is called as a cuticle. Okay, these are the parasitic parenchyma, this is a spongy parenchyma. Like this, the structure internally the leaf is provided with. Okay, yes, another point is, only the green plant area can prepare its own food. Only the leaf is in green color? No, the leaf is not only the green color. The stems are green in color. Okay, the branches are also green in color. And all these parts also, the photosynthesis, in the all these areas also photosynthesis it will be takes place. Let me say one more point. In the desert plants, there are no leaves. Okay, that is the reason more stomatal openings will be present to reduce the transpiration level. The leaves are reduced, like I said, cord-like structures. Even though if the leaf is there, the leaf is very small and it is coated with a wax coating. And the stem of the desert plant is very green in color, succulent stems we can say. Those stems are useful for the preparation of photosynthesis. Okay, so by utilizing all these the parts, the plant can, it prepares itself. The whole food, that particular process will call it as a photosynthesis. So other than these components, plant also needs the nitrogen. Okay, what is the other component? I said the four components. No, other than that, there is another component also required, and when you can say that the component is called as a protein. Okay, the protein is nothing but we can say this is a nitrogenous substance. Nitrogenous substance. So how these plants will get the nitrogenous substance? Okay, you know that the farmers used to spray the Nagarjuna urea, nitrogen content, the fertilizers to the plants. So through that, the plant will take the nitrogen. Instead of that, plants are also takes the nitrogen from the soil. Okay, yes, but the thing is here, plant need the nitrogen for the growth, but plant cannot use the nitrogen directly. So what the plant will do means, plant will depends upon the bacteria, and this bacteria converts nitrogen into the simple forms. Okay, in IC class I'll say that the simple forms, and these simple forms nothing but we'll call it as a nitrates and then nitrites. So this component, how this nitrogen is present taken by the plant means, from the soil, with the conversion of help of the bacteria converts the nitrogen into the simple. So plant utilizes the nitrogen and it maintains its growth. So these are all the comes under the palm of the photosynthesis. And the next one is it. The next topic is given. I'll close with this. Is it all the leaves are green in color? No, all the leaves are not in green color. The different colors the leaves it will be. See, I what are the leaves I have in my house? Just I'm showing. You can pick up both leaves from your home as you're staying in the holidays. So if you see this leaf, the leaf is green, violet in color. So this is not because of the pigment called as a chlorophyll. Okay, I don't want to say the names of that, it will be confused. Xanthophyll, leucoplus, carotene, all these are the different types of the chlorophyll molecules. With the help of that, photosynthesis will take place. The point what is given in your textbook is, all the leaves are not in green color. Okay, with the help, because of the different pigments, they are in different color. This is a violet. See, this leaf, if you observe, it's a green in color, and the middle there is a white in color because of the leucoplus. Sometimes the croton leaves are yellow in color. They are due to the because of xanthophyll. Okay, yes. So, see that this leaf, if you observe, it is a green in color on the surface. If you see the lower surface, it's a red in color. Is it clear? Can you see clearly? Yes. So, if you observe this leaf, and the total leaf is in the green color, and the middle it will be the pink in color. Okay. Yes. There will be the one more type of leaves, and these are all small, the violet color leaves. Okay. With this, it is clear for you children. All the leaves are not in green in color. They are in different colors because of different types of the chlorophyll. So, but is that leaves is not preparing the food? Yes or no? Yes, they are also preparing the food. Okay, yes. With this, let me conclude that. Just imagine that there is no photosynthesis process. The plants are not preparing their food, not preparing their own food. Can you see any plant on the earth? No. Just imagine, without the plant, is the sustainability of the living organisms will be simple? No, we cannot survive. We are indirectly or directly, we are depending on the plants, not only for the food and many other things. Okay, if there are no plants, there is no oxygen. If there are no plants, there is no rainfall, soil. If there is no other plant, underground water levels decrease as the rainfall is less. Okay, soil erosion occurs. These are all the problems. That's the reason. Save plants. Okay, children, I'll take a stop here, and we'll continue tomorrow and with the other topic. That's all for today. Thank you.